Yeah, good morning team. Welcome back to Maths Cloud. So today we are going to touch base the cycle counting accuracy method. So one of the accuracy method in inventory management. So we'll deep dive on this particular topic today. So cycle counting method is one of the frequent method, I mean to say, in the cloud application. If it is for the cloud, any version, if you take this cycle counting method, will be used widely. And also this particular frequency method, we can drive it either daily or weekly or monthly based on the frequency of setup, what the requirement we have. So as per that, we can do this particular cycle counting method in a customization manner. So before going to touch base the system, so what exactly as a functional consultant, we have to do the work here. So first we need to define classes, ABC classes. So this is the first setup, what it is required in your inventory management. So first we need to define how many classes we required. So we required in our system. So let's say we have a some 1,000 items are there. 1,000 items are there. So this particular thing we can segregate, or we can make as a group, as a class A, class A, class B, and class C. So class D. So how many classes you want? We can group this example. As per this example, in the 1,000 items, I will make 250 items is class C, and class B is 250 items, and similarly class C is rest of the 500 items. So like that, first you have to define how many classes you require in the cycle counting method. So once it is been completed, the next one is ABC classification set. So here, what we are trying to do is whatever classes which we created. So in this ABC classification set, so we have a controlling method, whether this classification we are going to apply for sub-inventory level or inventory level. All these kind of things we are going to do in the ABC classification set. Okay. So in this one, touch by the system, I'll show that how this classification set will be configured. So there is one concept, like let me quickly open the application. If I go to classification set, okay, if I click on plus, yeah, content scope and valuation scope, these are very important guys. Content scope and valuation scope. So content scope either org and sub-inventory level, and if it is sub-inventory level, so here either valuation scope will go with the organization sub-inventory. So So we have to take one of the example, then we can explain that. But I'll explain this particular thing, this concept. So in next version, I'm going to say cycle B, part 2B, when I'm doing time, I will explain. Currently, the content scope, I'm blindly going with the organization. Organization means under this organization, whatever sub-inventories which you have, for all these things, this particular classification set will be applicable. Now, before I am going to go in detail, so first what I said, ABC classes. So ABC classes, very simple, just to go to ABC classes and define class A, class B, class C. This is very simple setup. Nothing more effort is required here. So I don't want to create multiple. I want to go with this class A, class B, class C. So once it has been done, so here, so Yeah, so here the cycle count when you are doing, we have to make sure in which organization you are trying to do that. So I wanted to change this organization 001. Yeah, so first make sure when you are creating the classes, you have to create under the organization. That is important, guys. Okay, so like that class A, class B, I create now. So always remember accuracy method we're going to apply with respect to org level. Okay, now I'm doing the classification set. So let me create my own classification set. So now I am in the 001 ABC classification set. So I'm going to give some date here, P24, because there are multiple we have, so I don't want to discriminate. I mean to say differentiate, right? So content scope, I'm going with the organization. Criteria is important, whether you wanted to make a classification of item cost, on-hand quantity, on-hand value. So like that, there are multiple options we have. So currently, I'm not aware, like, you know, what is the cost of the items which is present in the system, because we have been not been using this particular system very frequently. So I'm going with the on-hand quantity criteria. Okay. And since you selected vendor scope is organization, so by system by default will consider under this organization, whatever sub-inventories which you have, everything it will be applicable. Right. So now, here, any additional information, nothing we have. So then submit it. Then submit. Now, in background, there some schedule job will run. So once the schedule job has been completed, so here status will come as complete. Okay, so let us verify that. Tools. Schedule process. No, this classification set has been successful. Now, we just refresh this. Now it has been completed. So now once you click on this view ABC classification set items, become it. Now system will pull whatever items which are present in this inventory organization system, pull everything. Now where we are going to do this kind of activity is first to download this particular thing. So before that, I'll give some heads up on this. See here, cumulative quantity means first it will be 1000 and then 1995, 1985, and then this one again, this one it will become like this. This is the cumulative. So because we selected what do you call a criteria is on-hand contours. Now, once you download that, then I want to segregate these things. So how to segregate? So this is the manual activity as of now. So we need to do like this. So let me select, let me check how many items we have. I have a count 199. Oh, sorry, 519. So here I'll keep classes. So let me keep A class A. So this one I want to put it for 100 items. Number items class A, and then class B. So this one I'll keep for till 400 something. And rest of the things will be lost. So where, I mean, after doing this, where I have a provision to append these things that we are going to see now. Okay. So this is the way I segregated the file. So once you create your valuation set, you just view that and then download it and prepare your Excel file. After that, so that's all classification set. Now it has been completed. Now click on done. Now you go to third program, third configuration is ABC assignment groups. ABC assignment groups. So now click on plus. So now here you see assignment group 16, 03, 2024. So my classification set is this one. Okay. Now ABC class, ABC classes will be added here. So sequence. So here this is important, guys. So now till class A, how till class A for how many for how many items? If you see here, yes. So let me handle this. So till 100. 100, okay. It start from 3, right? So let me count it. Only sequence. This is a sequence, not that sequence. 98, okay. So till 98, it is class A. So sequence is till, if you give 98, it will consider from 1 to 98. This is class A. Class A. No. Now class B is 99 to 397, not 398. 398 is class B. 398 is class B. 398. Next. So class C will start last. Plus. So that's what we downloaded, that particular thing. Less importance, medium, most. Save it and then save and close. So once it has been done, then we need to perform ABC assignments. Perform ABC assignment. So click on that. So once you've done that, it will create a schedule program. Okay, again it is asking. So all right. This class C is 98. Class B. B. Okay. Class A this one. So you just verify here an item. 98, what is the 98 item? A 5025. This is PM class B. Yes, CM6 by 0. Okay, very good. And then submit. So system will run. Okay. Process ID has been done now. Right. It is performing now. Once it has been completed, so we'll wait for some time. Because as soon as once we have more, it will take a bit of time. It has been succeeded. Now, let's refresh. When you click on this update, so any updates will happen, then you need to click on that. I'm going to say any new items will come into this inventory organizations. We need to click on this. Now, let me open this update. So now, I mean, we are not doing anything, just I wanted to check whether all the items has been classified into class A, class B or not. So just cancel it. Now everything has been done properly. Now after completion of this, then final step is, so we should have a inventory manager role, and we should have a job role of inventory manager as well as that access for that inventory admins. So once you have that, then if you go to supply chain execution, go to inventory management. Go to inventory management. So here we'll create it, and you know, the next session we'll see how to process it. Okay. Now here I'm going to accounts, create. Cycle count. Create cycle count. Now count name. Cycle count. 1603 2024. So it will come like include. Okay, include like this. So I want to include all the 71 people. So there is one possibility, like cycle count by item category. That particular concept we'll see in the further session. Right now we are doing with normal. Include and then include. Now after that, we need to append your assignment group. So our assignment group we added will come here. Okay. And then this particular thing, this is synchronization mode. So now we need to keep the synchronization mode into the complete mode. So what is the purpose of this is, when you keep this one as completed mode, so moment once you create it, once you go to the defined classes and items, based on your grouping of class A, class B, class C, system automatically pull all the items and display into the sector plan. Let's see that. Now that's all here. So this is complete. Append changes means whenever, for example, right now, first time when you are running, we need to keep this one as completed mode and then finish the parameters, all kind of stuff. But appended changes which are required for incremental changes. The time you have to go to the append changes. Once you keep this one, and after completion of that appending changes, new changes, it will come automatically to the manager. Okay, now click on next. So here, frequency, that is what I'm telling. So frequency is automatic schedule. When you want to do automatic schedule, system will do based on a frequency. When you want to run manually, it also can run. So I I wanted to do automated schedule, frequency by period, daily, weekly. So you can define whichever you want. So I want to keep weekly. One day operations is like the calendar will pull it up from here. So when it is next schedule. If it is daily, tomorrow. If it is weekly, so next week I'll keep Saturday, next Saturday. Okay, next schedule it is this one. Now approvals. So whether any kind of deviation will come, whether you wanted to send this one for approval or not. Yes, I need approval. Approval you want for always or out of tolerance. So I will go for always. Out of tolerance means you will give some tolerance percentage here. So based on that, only when deviation will happen. For example, let's say on hand quantity is 100. Now deviation I given 10%. So if it is 110 or 90, if it is 110, 990, it won't go. If it is 110, beyond 110 or less than 90, system will trigger the approval process. So that is the tolerance percentage kind of stuff. So that's what I wanted to go with the always approval type is always. And then click on it. And what is the counting sequence you want for your items? So I wanted to give 1603 2024 based on my page. Okay, maximum days before late. So how many days we can wait to finish this particular thing? I want to wait for one day. Maximum recounts. How many times you need to recount whenever deviation will be huge? Then I want to do only one thing. And when you want to complete the cycle count, what is the end date? End date I want to give so till next March. Okay. And then manual count allowed. You wanted to allow manual count. Then the count zero quantity, display suggested quantity. So these are self-explanatory, guys. So I don't want to do manual counting. Count to zero quantity also can be. And serial number per count, whether it is one or multiple. I want to go for one. Serial discrepancy allowed. If you want, you can enter this. Positive hit miss percentage, negative hit miss percentage. So far to determine the accuracy. So 1% I want to give. And here serial discrepancy allowed. Permit item number entered to be assigned to a different location. I don't want to go for that. So this is your based on your requirement. Serial number per counts one means if it is serialized item, for example, let's say we have a n quantity, for each quantity the serial number will be assigned. So I wanted to generate the counting sequence by single quantity wise. Okay. Serial number adjustment if possible, review or adjustment. So adjustment if possible, I will go. Now that's all here. Now what you see after this defining parameters, you need to save it. The next schedule must be working day. Okay. Yeah, so it is not working day. Go back to this next schedule date will be 2015. Save it. Okay. So we should not go to the next tabs, next time stops. First you need to do that activity. And then once you complete that, click on done. Manage cycle counts. The cycle count came. This is the one which you did. Now click on the cycle count name. See, automatically it has synchronization mode came to none. It means that System has pulled all the items, and then it will display into your the year fifth tab, sorry, sixth tab. Okay, let us go there. So if it is item category wise, see where I'm in different classes and items. See, automatically these items came. So we are not include, we are not done manual process. That is the synchronization mode advantage, guys. Okay. Now, how many times you need to count per year? Per year, weekly once, right? So I wanted to do roughly 100 times. So adjustment, tolerance, quantity variance, hit and miss. So this, what do you call, percentage if you want to give, can you? Right now, I'm not giving. And then we need to include in schedules. So how to select multiple here? That is what another challenge here. If I go to here, Control A. So you keep the cursor at last. Oh, sorry, 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 sorry. For that, the last, select multiple. This is a bit of problems. Usually test to. It should come. Okay, so the selection should be multiple way. It's not happening. I think I have to go online. You have to click, double click on this each and every row to select one and one. Okay, so I am finding. So now you just click on include schedule. The rest of the things you have to do like that. This is a one-time activity. And then similarly go to class B. It should work actually. It's not working. They have to give some sign of option here. Okay, so I will select only few now. It's a concept understanding. Oh. happening? Okay, so like that you have to select. I'm so sorry, I'm unable to find out what is option here. So just select it or something. All right. So once it is done, simply save it, and then if you want to do the review, you can review it, all the parameters, save it, and then save and close. Okay. So rest of the process we'll see in the take account part B section. So what we have done? We created a classes, classification set, assignment group, and then created a cycle count parameters. And then we took like a weekly automatic schedule by weekly. So rest of things will be very simple. That, you know, if I stretch now, may more than half an hour it will go. That is what I want to stop now. And thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much of your keenly support for my particular channel. And if anybody require a support, I'm going to stop now. So this is now. Let me go back. So if anybody, suppose for example, let's say the career has been started very recently, I mean to say very freshly for them, that like they are going to stuck during their day-to-day activities, please approach me and definitely I'm going to help you people. Okay. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you for your support. Have a great day. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye. And we'll see next maximum 1 or 2 days, I'm going to release that part B in the cycle count description. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye-bye.